In English, more like Uber. And then the last letter is the S set. It's like a B, but it doesn't connect like normal B. It has a separation here. And all that stands for is the German shorthand way of writing a double S. There's certain grammar rules in which it's used, but for our purposes, we won't focus on the technicalities of the grammar on that. So, again, the difference is, how these are different is that this is an accent of the letter A. This is an accent of the letter O, and this is an accent of the letter U. The difference in spelling, like many languages, the accent changes the sound in which the letter is spoken. For example, without an umlaut, it is pronounced A. With it, it's pronounced E, sort of like E. So this is like the equivalent of the German letter E, E. This is pronounced O, and this is pronounced E. So like in the word, können, which is the German word for to be able to or can. Then you have U, which comes from, is an accented version of U. And this is simply pronounced S. Yes. By the way, if it's one S, it's pronounced Z, like a Z. If it's two S's, it sounds like an S. So how that word goes. And oftentimes they equal it to this symbol.
So you probably won't see two S's, you'll just see the
In German, there was a particular grammar on when it exists and when it doesn't. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, Straße, which means straight, as opposed to das. There's no real clear reason why this is, just because, other than Germans made it so.
Okay.
Also, you guys don't have this, but we'll go over the letters. We'll focus first on consonant combinations. Sort of like in English, like diphthongs, you guys familiar with what a diphthong is? Whenever two vowels are hooked together, it produces a different sound. Yeah. Similar thing with consonants. The first one is this. Like you saw in the word ich, it's pronounced like a sh, but without the s at the beginning. Like sh. Almost like in the word. Is that how you spell hue? Is that how you spell
yeah.
Hue, the English word? Hue. Like that sh, the sh. It can also have a hard depending on its position as kh, like in the word machen. Yes, which means to make or do something. Another example will be the X, which is just sounds like a K, S, so X. You have the QU, which unlike in English, which is pronounced like Qu. In German, it's pronounced like a K, V, U. Yes, but a lot of times, so if there was like, for example, in the German word Quellen, which is like sources you use for a research paper, it's pronounced Quellen. Yes. Another one, and also in German they have these letters, PF. And also KN. PF is pronounced like P and F smushed together, so it's like pff. So like the word Pferd means horse, Pferd. And kn, like in the word knie, which is a German word for your knee. In English, you probably know, so it also has a K. That's why it does, is because the word knee comes from a German derivative. The only difference is the Germans actually pronounce the K. Okay. Right. pronounces like a TS. Yes. Like in the word. Zotzi. Zotzi. That is an abbreviation for a political party. The long name is really long, so they call them Zotzis. The long name would be the Soziale Demokratische Partei Deutschlands.
Well, maybe
Yes.
Sure.
Even German speaks short, because even Germans get frustrated with their own words sometimes. So, the important thing to recognize is the W. It's not, the W sound does not exist like it does in English. It just doesn't exist in other language. Instead, it sounds like a V. So, whenever you see those like famous cars, you probably know this one. Company, Volkswagen. This V sounds like an F, and this one sounds like a V.
Volkswagen.
Those are the basic ones. There's also all these letters like SCH, that's the German way of making sh. And any combination like ST, SP, SK, any combination with S and another consonant, there's an invisible sh in it. It's not spelled like this, but it's pronounced sh. There's like an invisible sh in it. It's not like in English where you'd be like, there's a sh in it. Okay. Diphthongs. Diphthongs, the combination, there are a few combinations. There's AU makes OW. This combination comes from, of course, A sounds like A, and U sounds like U. So the combination together makes OW. Then you have EI and IE. This one's pronounced E, and this one's pronounced I. A good way to remember this is I before E makes E, and E before I makes I. As far as whenever you think about it in English.
Or you can take the last vowel, the long sound with the last vowel sound.
Yes. However, that does not work in all cases. For example, anyone want to figure out, try to say how that, do you think that would be pronounced?
Oi.
Oi. Oi. Oi. This is pronounced, a lot of people would want to try to say eu, because technically e is e and u is u. But in matter of fact, it's pronounced oi, like in boy. The same sound is also pronounced in this combination as well. That's also oi. The reason why that is, like I said here, this sounds like e, e, so it produces the same thing as if it were. And a lot of times you see things like this in like examples like the German word for a house. And then if you want to make that plural, they do that in pronounce Häuser. So that's what happens. A lot of times that's in the plural. Other examples would be we got those. Let's see. One missing. Aha! I knew I was missing one. This sound I is also can be like that. This is not as common as this one, but you'll find letters like this, like in the word Kaiser, the German word for emperor, for example. Few others include, actually, I think here. Yeah, there's not many of them actually. There are other combinations, like for example, you could put UE, but that's not a diphthong in German. You pronounce those separately. So, like in the word this has a diphthong. diphthong and an opdiphthong. You see three vowels together, but there's a separation sound. This is the oi, and the feuer. German word for fire.
Feuer.
So.
Feuer.
Feuer.
You hear that?
Okay. Do you guys send the email?
Kelly, send the email. Mm-hmm. She can open it up.
Trying to find Jan.
Well, we're working on that. We'll skip a little bit ahead and talk about...
You got the email on April 6th. If you have your computers with you, you can open up. There's an attachment that we're going to be showing and Jaeger's going to be using.
You guys are going to get to speak.
As you're looking at these letter combinations up here, it'll probably resonate with you a little more when you're actually using them in words, because you'll become more accustomed to using them in specific words and hearing them in specific words.
While she's working on that, we're going to skip a little ahead and talk about the basic cases of the German language. In the German language, words take either one of three basic genders, either masculine, feminine, or gender. And the and they have articles which are attached to each one. Those verbs are those articles are known as der, die, das, the words for sein. Der is for masculine. Die is feminine, and das is neuter. Learning these is all important. Whenever you learn any new German word, it's always important to learn the article. Because the article will determine everything else, from what adjective endings it gets, to what part of speech of the article, because these articles do change. It's not like, for example, you may be familiar with Spanish with the el, la, los, las, that kind of thing. Those are the four. German's a little bit more complicated. There's about 16 different combinations of the words a or a, depending on the part of speech. We're not going to go into that much detail, but that's basically how it works. These are important ones to know. In the nom de case is der, die, das. For example, der Mann, which means the man. Man is masculine, so therefore it takes the masculine article. Die Frau is a woman. Das Haus, neuter.
The what?
Das Haus.
Is the what?
It's the house. Like you live in, like.
So there's three genders, masculine, feminine, and neuter. It's not just applied as if we're speaking about a woman or a man. For example.
Yes, I was going to get to that. Now, unlike some other languages where it is strictly to male or feminine objects, just because it's something you might consider masculine or feminine doesn't necessarily take that case. For example, you have. Das Mädchen. Mädchen is a little girl. One would think that being a girl, it would be feminine. Mm-hmm. But instead, it takes a neuter case.
Is that because it's plural or just randomly?
No, if this was plural, the article would be changed to D.
Okay.
D is the plural for any of these cases.
Okay.
So it doesn't matter if it's so if it was daemon and then you turned it into and then it would go to D mena. This would turn into the fallen. And this would turn into the poison. So D is plural for all cases. It's also the same in the single case for feminine verbs.
So they just decide to put the gas as like explain that with the little girl again?
Well, with Mädchen, this is partially why they did it. Mädchen does not have, like you see here how the word turns the man to mena. It changes.
Uh-huh.
Mädchen is Mädchen in both cases.
Okay.
It's Mädchen, so it's das Mädchen is one girl, die Mädchen is two or more.
Okay.
That's how it works. But then you have other cases, like for example, you have Junge, which means boy. It is masculine, but takes a feminine ending, what would be considered traditionally a feminine ending in German.
Can you say that one again?
Der Junge. Junge is also related to the German word Jung, which means young. So they're basically saying young ones is what a boy is essentially called. That good? And then, of course, the versions of this as A verbs, or not verbs, articles is ein, eine, and ein. And this is masculine, feminine, and neuter. The neuter and the masculine are the same. Yes.
So since you said that with the young one, so since it started with dare, it would be the young boys?
Yes, this translated into English means boys.
Okay.
Or one boy.
Okay.
If it's many boys, it is the, can you add an N? The Jungen.
Okay.
I think I got this up now. One second. Dialogue.
Is the projector on?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get to the right page on this document. Okay. You guys get to speak now.
Yay.
Okay. We're going to go through this dialogue known as getting to know people on basically you're getting off an airport, and you're introduced with a person and stuff, and they ask you questions and things like that. We're going to go through this, and each sentence I'll point in each of you, and you will say the sentence out loud.
We both took her number.
Understand?
Everyone got that?
Yeah.
Okay. First line is pretty easy. Guten Tag. Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Womit?
Womit?
Kann
ich
Ihnen dienen?
Ihnen.
Good job.
Ich suche meine Koffer.
Good job.
Ihr Name bitte.
Meaning your name, please.
Casey.
Well, We're focusing on pronunciation right now, and then we'll go through the meanings.
Gotcha.
Then name is Mark Smith.
Mine.
Name.
Nama.
Nama is Mark Smith.
Yes. That's it.
Aus
den
Vereinigten
Staaten. Yes. Try that one more time.
Ich komme
aus den Vereinigten Staaten. Yes. Meaning I come from the United States. Okay. Good job. Back to you.
How's it going?
Informally speaking. There's a formal and informal way. This is the informal way. Sounds like a Y. Las. This is that funny little B thing that's actually an S. Las. It looks like a diphthong, but this is a special case to where it's not family, it's familie. So that's the exception to the rule. Okay, the sentence continues. Vorstellen. Good job. this way. And surely go.
And should again is an important word.
It is indeed.
It means excuse me.
Can we practice saying that word?
And should again.
Entschuldigung.
Entschuldigung.
There are two words. There's Entschuldigung, which is basically the like noun version, but sometimes people. There's two ways. If you're just saying excuse with noun, it's Entschuldigung. But if you're asking someone specific to excuse you, it's Entschuldigen Sie. Yes.
So if we bump into somebody, we say.
Most of the time, Germans would just say Entschuldigung or sorry.
Oh,
that's
okay, yes.
No, don't say sorry.
Yeah. Most.
We can handle that one. Sorry.
The thing is, a lot of English has polluted. Per se, the German language. So we say a lot of English in our everyday speech, technically, we're supposed to say Entschuldigung, but a lot of times we just go, sorry, with a German accent. Okay. Who is next?
Zum Teufel.
Zum Teufel. Literally means, to the devil. It's like saying, heck. Zum Teufel. There's more harsh ways of translating that, but basically it's like, oh my god, basically. Next.
Geduld, Mark.
Geduld, Mark.
Elliot
yeah.
In Germany.
Okay, yeah.
Das so. Etwas.
Etwas.
Das war.
Passiert.
Passiert, okay.
Means thank you, bitte means you're welcome. Bitte means actually a bunch of things in German, but in this case, that means you're welcome. Okay. Now, to go over the meanings of this. So, this is people going, they're just coming in and they're needing to get their bags and stuff like that. So, he begins by saying Guten Tag. It's a formal way of saying good day, hello, whenever it's midday. If it was morning, it would be Guten Morgen. And if it was afternoon, which in Germany is any time after 5, is Guten Abend. And if it's night, it's Gute Nacht. And that's used sort of like the same way in English whenever someone's going to sleep. But then the clerk continues by saying, Guten Tag, womit kann ich Ihnen helfen? With what can I help you? Then Mark goes, ich suche meine Koffer. I'm looking for my suitcases.
Yes.
And then clerk says, Ihr Name bitte? Asking for your name, what's your name? There's many different ways this can happen, like wie heißen Sie? Like we did at the beginning of the class. This is another way of simply saying your name. They can also ask, was ist dein Name? There's many different ways to do that. Mark goes, mein Name ist Mark Smith, of course. Woher kommen Sie? Where do you come from? He replies with, ich komme aus den Vereinigten Staaten. I come from the United States. So, or you could just say, ich komme aus Amerika. Or you could say, ich komme aus den USA. The USA. Then Mark, here, click says, Ihre Flugnummer? A Flugnummer is like your flight number. Flug means flight, Nummer is a number. He replies by saying, 303 aus New York. 303 from New York. Einen Moment bitte. Give me a moment, please. Tag, also Tagmark, wie geht's? This is another person that comes over to him, like one of his friends or something. Was Tagmark, wie geht's? A informal way of greeting friends. Wie geht's? It's like saying what's up or what, how's it going, that kind of thing. Just formal chit-chat, basically, between friends. Formally, you wouldn't say this. Formally, you would say, wie geht es Ihnen? Whenever you're talking to someone formally, either someone of a higher position than you or someone you don't know. Mark then replies, Hans, mir geht's gut, und dir? It goes to me well, and you? A lot of times they would just say gut, but the formal, the actual like way to say it would be es, there's many ways. This is mir geht's gut, or you say es geht mir gut. So mir means to me, geht is goes. This is, what do you call that in English whenever two words are smushed together? Contraction between geht and the word es, goes it. So literally saying, to me goes it well. That's the German way of saying it. So like speaking Old English almost. Almost like Yoda or something. Und dir and to you. Dir means to you, as opposed to just you. Du is you, dir means to you. Sehr gut. Bist du hier auf Ferien? Are you here on vacation? Ferien is a vacation. There's also another word known as Urlaub, but you can also use this one, Ferien. Then, ja, lass mich dir meine Familie vorstellen. Meine Frau Mary, meine Tochter Anna und mein Sohn John. Vorstellen means to introduce something. So he's basically saying, yes, let me to you, my family, introduce. My wife. Frau in German means woman, it can also mean wife. So in a way, when if you say this is my wife, you're just simply saying this is my woman. Same thing with a husband, you just say this is my man. Yeah. There used to be a word in older versions of German for wife, it was called Weib, but German no longer uses that because it's considered to be a derogatory to women because of the feminist movement. So they no longer be like being called wife, they prefer being called woman. So, Hans then replies nett, which means nice. Sie kennen zu lernen. Nice to meet you. Kennen zu lernen is a long verb, as you can tell. It means to get to know someone. The lernen comes from to learn, kennen is to recognize, and the zu is the infinitive like to. So, literally, it's recognize to learn. So to get to know someone is kennen zu lernen. Then clerk goes up and says, Entschuldigen Sie, excuse me please. Mein Herr, my sir, it's a formal way of Germans basically saying, sir, it's like getting your attention, like meine Frau, or they wouldn't necessarily say Frau, they would just say Frau, or mein Herr. Then, also die Koffer kommen mit der nächsten Maschine. The suitcases come with the next machine, like the little roundabout things you see in the airports. Okay. Then he replies with zum Teufel, because he has to wait. Like, why do I have to wait here? Zum Teufel, to the devil. Then Geduld mag. Geduld means patience, mag. So, Geduld. Also the adjective that is geduldig for being patient. Das so etwas passiert. So, das so etwas passiert, that's something that happens. This is like the German way of just saying things happen, basically. Things like that happen, basically. Then, danke, thanks, bitte, you're welcome, and auf Wiedersehen. It's a formal way of saying goodbye, literally meaning on the union. Other ways of saying goodbye would be like tschüss or ciao, and sometimes they even say bye. But this is the German way of saying it, auf Wiedersehen. Okay. Now we've gotten to that part.
Okay.
Everyone stand up.
Thank you.
choosing one other person, you're going to go through this. One of you is going to follow this line. Good day. My name is so-and-so. How are you? Then you reply. Just talk to each other, practice. Two groups and then switch around. However you want to do it. Was ist das? What is this? Anyone remember the word for go?
Das ist ein Mädchen.
Good job. Was ist das? And you reply with das ist. We haven't gone over die Katzen, die Hunde, the cats and the dogs. Was sind das? Die Häuser. Good job. Additional practice, greetings and farewells. Greetings can be anything, like I said before. Guten Morgen is good morning, guten Tag, good day, guten Abend, good evening, and gute Nacht, good night. Other ways like hallo is just a casual way of saying hi. There are other different ways, since for your purposes you're going to the southern part of Germany in Austria. A lot of people there say either Grüß dich Gott, which literally means God greets you. It's a Bavarian dialect way of just saying hi. Or they say Grüß Gott, which is basically the same thing. Or Servus, which is what I say in my dialect. Those are what you will commonly hear in the south. Servus, Grüß Gott, or Grüß dich Gott. Farewells include Auf Wiedersehen, a formal way of saying goodbye. Auf Wiedersehen. Just saying bye is Tschüss. Yes. And that's spelled. Basically like ch, like an English ch, and then ch, and then a double s. Shus. Yes. Okay. Likes and dislikes, we will actually come back to that. For now, we're going to take a short break. You guys can stand up, stretch, go get some water or something. We're going to have a 5 to 8 minute break or so. And what of the object is. Or if you don't, it's nein, no, ich mag Hausaufgaben nicht. The nicht means not, and it comes at the end.
So it's kind of backwards.
Yeah. Oh. You're literally saying,
okay.
It's like old English almost. Like, instead of saying, like in German, if I want, you would say, I don't know.
Uh-huh.
And German says, I know not.
Okay.
That kind of thing. Or, I like the homework
not. Okay,
so sort of like that concept.
I like homework.
Sort of like that concept when you'd be like, oh blah blah blah. Nah.
Okay.
Fine. So magst du Hausaufgaben?
Nein, ich mag Hausaufgaben nicht.
Nicht. Good. Flasche.
Flasche.
Magst du?
Magst du
die Flasche?
Die Flasche?
Do you like it?
Yes.
Oh, no.
Ja.
Ja, ich
mag
die
Flasche.
Aha. One more time.
Ja, ich.
Computer. Magst du das Computer?
Ja, ich mag das Computer.
Good job. We're going to switch over. We're going to use this one.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. No, not me.
Fenster. Gefällt das Fenster dir? Fenster goes here. Fenster.
Okay.
Window.
Window.
Sorry.
Ja.
Ja.
Fenster.
Das Fenster.
Das Fenster.
Gefällt.
Gefällt.
Mir.
Okay.
One more time.
Oh, okay.
Gefällt das Fenster dir?
Das Fenster.
Fenster.
Fenster. Gefällt mir.
Gefällt mir. Good job.
Okay.
Okay. Der Tisch. Gefällt der Tisch dich? Dir?
Gefällt der Tisch dich?
Dir. Gefällt der Tisch dir?
Yeah. I have a question. What is the gefällt dich dir mean again?
It's the same thing as magst. Do you
okay.
like something? These are two
version.
Different ways. The difference in literal translation
like
is...
Table?
Yes.
Nine. What's the table again?
Tisch.
Tisch. Nein.
And it's der Tisch.
Der Tisch.
Gefällt
mir nicht.
Good job.
Oh.
The same thing, but in little translation, this is literally do you like it?
Okay.
This is the little do you like it. This comes from the verb mögen, to like something.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just a conjugation of mögen.
Okay.
This comes from the word sich. Gefallen, to please oneself. So it's like a more uppity way of saying things, I guess.
Okay.
No, I don't want this one here next. Das Handy. Magst du das Handy?
Wait. It's a phone. Yeah.
The question or the answer? Magst du das Handy?
Das Handy.
Mm-hmm.
Das Handy.
You, I said this one, so you reply with this.
Oh, so like saying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, ich mag.
Ja, ja oder nein?
Ja.
Ja, ich mag.
Ich mag.
Das Handy.
Das Handy.
Good. Alright, and one more. Die Tür. Die Tür. Gefällt die Tür dir? So, do you like it or not like it? So you begin with ja.
Oh yeah, ja.
Die Tür.
Die Tür.
And the rest. Gefällt.
Gefällt.
Mir.
Mir.
Yes. One more time. Ja.
Ja.
Die Tür.
Die Tür.
Gefällt. Mir.
Mir.
Good job. Okay, next set of questions. Woher kommen Sie? By the way, this is informal, by the way. If it was formal, it would be gefallen es Ihnen, and this would be mögen Sie das. It would still be answered the same way, but the question would change because of the form here. This is in the formal case. Woher kommen Sie? Where do you come from?
Can you say that one more time?
Woher kommen Sie? And you would play high with, ich komme aus Mäufer. Woher kommen Sie?
Ich komme aus Asheville, North Carolina.
Woher kommen Sie?
Ich komme aus North Carolina.
North Carolina. Woher kommen Sie?
Ich komme aus Tennessee.
Tennessee. Woher kommen Sie?
Ich komme aus Stokes County.
Woher kommen Sie?
Ich komme aus Bostic.
Bostic.
North Carolina.
Woher kommen Sie? You just say where you're from, county.
Okay.
Ich komme aus.
Okay.
Say the whole first. Yeah. You say,
yeah.
You're replying to the question, woher kommen Sie? And you reply with, ich komme aus, and where are you from? I won't bother too much about like translating every single last major unless you want to know. Sometimes they don't necessarily translate. So,
inclusive.
What do you say? I will ask the question. Was studieren Sie?
Ich studiere.
Lehr means teaching. Amt is like a office of like a department. Lehramt. Okay. Was studieren Sie?
Ich studiere Inclusive Education.
Inclusive Education. Was studieren Sie? Also Lehramt. So. There's different words for that in German depending on the specification, but you could just say education or Lehramt.
Okay.
So, was studieren Sie?
Okay.
Ich studiere. Lehramt?
Lehramt.
Ja. Was studieren Sie?
Ich studiere History and Technology.
Geschichte und Technologie. If you want to try
it. Okay.
History is Geschichte. Geschichte und means and. And Technologie.
Technologie.
Ja. Was studieren Sie?
Lehramt.
Oh. one needs to know when going to a hotel, for example. These are the different items. So, we have die Küche, the kitchen. Well, this is, not all hotels have kitchens, but hostels do have kitchens. So, die Küche. Everyone?
Die Küche.
The kitchen. Der Herd. The D at the end of a word sounds like a T.
Yeah.
Stove. Der Kühlschrank.
Der Kühlschrank.
Yeah. The refrigerator. Die Treppe.
Die Treppe.
Die Toilette.
Die Toilette.
Das Waschbecken.
Das Waschbecken.
Das Wohnzimmer.
Das Sofa.
Das Fenster.
Das Fenster.
Der Tisch und die Stühle.
Der Tisch und die Stühle.
Der Tisch is the table, die Stühle are the chairs.
Can we say that again?
Der Tisch und die Stühle.
Der Tisch und die Stühle.
Die Tür.
Der
Flur.
Der
Garten.
Der Garten.
Das Bett.
Das Bett.
Das Schlafzimmer.
Das Schlafzimmer.
Der Wandschrank.
Der Wandschrank.
Das Badezimmer.
Das Badezimmer.
Die Badewanne.
Die
Okay. So, using the phrase, wie heißt das, blank auf Deutsch, is a way of saying, how do you say so-and-so in German? So, wie heißt couch auf Deutsch?
Oh my God.
Just look up.
Oh.
Yeah, can you read this?
Das Sofa.
Das Sofa.
Mhm. Wie heißt so Window auf Deutsch?
Das Fenster.
Mhm. Wie heißt the chairs and the tables auf Deutsch?
Der Tisch und die Stühle.
Wie heißt the door auf Deutsch?
Die Tür.
Good. Wie heißt bedroom auf Deutsch?
Das Schlafzimmer.
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 Wie heißt refrigerator? Auf Deutsch.
Kühlschrank.
Wie heißt the toilet auf Deutsch?
Die Toilette.
Wie heißt Staircase auf Deutsch?
Good job.
Uh-huh. Okay. Is that like a way to like want it? Okay. Single and close. These are also in your vocabulary on should be page, it's around page 21. Yeah, it's on page 22 and 21 as well. I added a few others and taken out a few because some are more important than others. Der Reisepass.
Der
Reisepass.
Der Reisepass.
Also known as just der Pass.
Der Pass.
That is a passport. So if anyone, if a police comes to you and be dein Reisepass bitte, then you know.
Here.
Take it.
Das Hotel.
Das Hotel.
Das Zimmer.
Das Zimmer.
That is a room. We're in a Zimmer.
Zimmer.
Der Preis.
Der
Preis. That is the cost or something, like the price, like a price tag or something. How much something costs. Das Badezimmer.
Das Badezimmer.
That's the bathroom, which for your purposes, since you're going to Southern Germany as well, Badezimmer is the formal Hochdeutsch. Hochdeutsch means High German, which is a standard German. But like it, many other languages, there are many dialects in German. In the south of Germany, a lot of times, the bathroom is referred to simply as the Toi. Or the Klo. And a way of saying, I'm going to the bathroom, and I say this a lot in my own dialect, is Ich gehe aufs Klo. Or Ich gehe aufs Toi. So a lot of times, Toi comes from the word Toilette, and it just gets shortened to Toi. And then Klo, I don't really know where that comes from, it's just a dialectal thing we call a bathroom or a toilet. So that's what a lot of times you hear that, Klo or Toi. But this is the formal standard German way of saying Das Badezimmer. In Germany also, the bathrooms and many different other international places will be marked with the letters W and C. In German known as the WC. So if you ever go in like train stations or hotels or anything and you see the letters WC, also known as WC in German, that's where the bathroom is.
Okay.
Die Reservierung.
Die Reservierung.
The reservation. Die Tür.
The door.
Das Zimmermädchen.
Das Zimmermädchen.
Literally means room girl, and that's like the maid. Sometimes they're also known, especially for the bathroom season in Germany, they have their bathrooms have what's called a Putzfrau, which sits there by the public bathrooms and waits for you and then cleans up after you. And you're supposed to pay them.
Huh.
In Germany, the public toilets are not free. Don't ever leave without tipping, because that's like one of the worst things you can do. So if you go to a public bathroom, a lot of times they'll have a block off, and you have to pay like a euro or something to get in the first place, to get into the public bathroom. And then whenever you turn, there's a lot of times an old lady sitting at a table waiting for people to tray, and you pay her like 20 cents at the time to use the bathroom. Because you basically tip for her services to clean up after you.
Hmm.
Das Fenster.
Oh, really?
Das Fenster.
Sorry, say that again.
No problem. Das Fenster.
Das Fenster.
The window. Die Stunde.
Die Stunde.
The hour. Now we'll talk about Fragewörter, question words. The question words in German are was, what, wo,
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 wer,
meaning who, wie,
wann,
warum,
warum,
wie viel,
wie viel.
Usages of was. Like we've used before, like was ist das? Very versatile saying, you just point to something in German, like, was ist das, and they will tell you what it is.
Okay.
Was ist das? What is that? Was sind das is the plural. What are those? Das means, das can mean that, this, those, or these. It uses, das is one of the most common words in German. But this is changing it. This basically is, and that's on. Was machst du? What are you doing? Or what are you making? It has both meanings. And was meinst du? What do you mean? A lot of times Germans will say this if they're talking in a conversation and one person didn't necessarily understood what they said, and they want, like, in the sense of, they heard what you said, but didn't understand your meaning. So they're like, plus mind store, what do you mean by that? That kind of thing. And these are informal. Anyone want to try to do the formal? Was machst du? What would be the form?
Was machen Sie?
And here? Was? In the formal? Was meinen Sie? Yes.
Okay.
Wer? Meaning who? Wer ist Who is he? So, for example, if I asked you, wer ist sie?
Sie ist Paige.
Sie ist Paige. Wer ist sie?
Sie ist Alex.
Wer ist Sie
ist Jim.
Jim. And wer ist Wer
ist Ellie.
Oh, she was.
Have you?
Well, that, she would be sie. Means he. Ist. Ist er?
Ist Dr. Weissel.
Yeah. Herr Doktor, you say. Herr Doktor, and then last name.
Herr Doktor. Herr Doktor Weissel.
Weissel, yes. Uh-huh. And same thing, wer sie and wer sind sie, who are they? For example, wer sind sie?
Wer sind sie? Casey.
Und? So you say, sie sind, and her name?
Casey.
Und?
Und Ellie.
Huh? One more time?
Wer sind sie, Casey, und Ellie.
Good job.
Good job.
You. Wer sind sie?
Which one?
These three.
All three of them.
Oh.
Sie sind
in the back.
Oh.
Sie sind.
Sie sind. Doctor sind. Sie sind. Sie sind Calvin.
Good job. Okay. Wer. Not to be confused with wer. It sounds similar to the English where.
Mm-hmm.
But it's
mm-hmm.
It's
actually
true. It's
who.
Okay. Wann. This is when in reference to time. Like, for example, wann kommt die nächste S-Bahn an? When does the next S-Bahn arrive? An S-Bahn is a mode of train transportation that goes over ground. There are many different types of transportation. All of them are referred to as Bahn. Like the Autobahn is known as the carway, like the highway basically.
Mm-hmm.
S-Bahn is a train that goes over ground, except for the places it goes underground, and an U-Bahn is a train that goes underground, except for the places it goes overground.
Huh.
So,
wow.
And then they have other things like Straßenbahn, Stadtbahn, basically anything with the word Bahn.
Okay.
So
transportation.
If you want to know when the next S-Bahn came, it would be wann kommt die nächste S-Bahn an? Wann gehen wir ins Kino?
Wann gehen wir ins Kino?
That means, when are we going to the movie theaters?
Ooh.
A kino is a movie theater. So when are we going to the movie theater? Wann machen wir das? When are we going to do that? Wann kommst du noch? When do you come? When are you going to come? Wann kommst du noch? So this is always used whenever you specifically want to know when in the sense of time. There are two other words for when, wenn and ob, but those are conjunctions. Is that the English word? Subordinating conjunctions. Yes. So wenn, ob. This is specifically when you're asking the question, when something's going to happen in reference to time. Wo, this means where. If you're stuck in Germany somewhere, you don't know where you are and you have a map, and you want to know where you are on the map, you would say, wo befinde ich mich auf der Landkarte? So, wo?
Wo?
Befindet?
Befindet?
Ich?
Ich?
Mich?
Mich?
Auf der, Landkarte?
Landkarte.
Wo befinde ich mich auf der Landkarte?
Wo befinde ich mich auf der Landkarte?
Ja. Or you could simply say, wo bin ich?
Wo bin ich?
Wo bin ich? Where am I?
Wo bin ich?
And just throw your hands up and down and hand on the map. Where am I?
Wo bin
ich? Wo komme ich dahin?
Wo komme ich dahin?
Where do I get there? Dahin doesn't have a literal translation. Hin is a measure of movement. There are two words is her, like whenever something is coming from somewhere to here. Like in the question, woher kommst du? Where do you come from? It's woher, where her, meaning from that place. It's like saying, where from somewhere over there to this place do you come? Hin is the opposite direction. So like, wo komme ich dahin? Where do I come that way to that place? And if you want to specify a certain place, like if you want to find the movie theater, you would say, wo komme ich zum Kino hin? The da represents just das, which is just any form of any noun that you're looking for. So if you're looking for some specific, you would just remove the da and add something you're looking for and end it with it.
Oh, okay.
And then, wo findet man Marienplatz? That's an example. Where does one find Marienplatz, which is a place in München, by the way, which you're going to.
Okay.
It's actually a nice little place if you want to go to. If you want to go to it, you ask for, wo findet man Marienplatz? And they will direct you to where it is. It has a lot of shops and restaurants. It's like, it's in the old type München city.
Okay.
Warum? Why? Just in case if you, but don't question police, don't ask police why. You might get in trouble.
Mm.
So, warum ist das Dorf so klein? Why is the village so small? Because there are villages that are like 300 years old, like the one I lived in, named Westernor. It's so small, it has like a bar, a post office, a bakery, a church, and the rest of houses. So it's like really small. So, those hats in the room. So, warum sitzen die ältere Generation immer?
Can you say that one again?
Warum
sitzen
die ältere Generation immer? Warum sitzen die ältere Generation immer?
Warum sitzen die Generation immer?
This translates to, why does the older generation speak always using the formal you? Sitzen is, it's actually not like typically considered a real word. It's a word used in order to explain, because the sitzen and duzen, that's the German verbs of explaining. To speak using sie and to speak using du. So if you're duzen, like if I would say, wir sind zum duzen, that means we are on terms to speak du to each other because we're that friendly. But if I said, wir sind zum Sitzen, that means we speak formally to each other, using sie or du. Warum muss man Wasser hier in Deutschland kaufen? Warum
muss man
Wasser
hier in Deutschland
kaufen? Why does one have to buy water here in Germany? Because water's not free. You can't go to a restaurant and be like, can I have a glass of water and give it? You have to pay for it. You might as well get beer, because a lot of times beer is cheaper. And, warning, German water, if you just ask for water, it's going to be carbonated. Because that's standard in Germany. So if you don't want carbonation, you have to specifically state that you don't want it. Like, for example, a lot of times there's different words for water, the normal water that they drink, which is with bubbles. They can call it Wasser mit Gas, Wasser mit Kohlensäure, Wasser mit Sprudel, things like that. But if you didn't want that, you can just say Leitungswasser, which is like tap water.
Oh, that's what
or you could say Wasser ohne Gas.
Ohne Gas.
That means without carbonation.
Ohne Gas.
So you say that, Wasser ohne Gas. And sometimes you have to specify if you want ice, because a lot of times normally they don't give you ice either. So if you want water with no bubbles but with ice, you would say Wasser ohne Gas und mit Eis.
Und mit Eis.
Yes.
Wie
means how.
Wie?
Like in the question that we asked, wie geht es Ihnen? How are you? Literally, how goes it to you?
Wie geht es
Ihnen? Wie geht es Ihnen? The formal. Also, wie heißen Sie? What is your name? This literally translates to, how are you called? So when you say, ich heiße, you're saying, I am called in your name.
Okay.
Wie machen Sie das Schnitzel hier?
Yeah.
How do they make the schnitzel here? It's a food. And it's not a hot dog. A lot of people think it's a hot dog for some reason. It's not. It's more like a cutlet pork thing. Wie ist das Wetter heute?
Wie ist das Wetter heute?
That is, how's the weather today? So.
Wie ist das Wetter heute?
Das Wetter heute ist, you need your verb.
Ist.
Heute.
Heute.
What would you like to say about the weather?
Nice.
Nett.
Nett.
Or schön is a better word in that case.
Schön.
So the sentence.
So, ist heute.
Das Wetter ist
das
heute.
Das Wetter heute ist schön.
Yes, you said ist twice. So, it's das Wetter ist heute.
Das Wetter ist heute.
Schön.
Schön.
Yes.
Okay.
Good job. So if anyone asks you that, you can say das Wetter ist schlimm. It's horrible. Das Wetter. Is schön, das Wetter ist. Schön means beautiful, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Basically, anything. Das Wetter ist heiß, the weather is hot outside, das Wetter ist kalt, it's cold, and so on and so on. Wie viel? How much? Wie viel kostet das? That will be used every time you go to a cash register. How much does that cost? Wie viel kostet das? So if you come to them and be like, here's the thing. A lot of times they would just scan it in most places and it will show up and they'll tell you. But if you ever need to ask, this is the first word. Wie viel kostet das? How much does it cost? Wie viel hast du denn gekauft? How much did you buy? By adding an E at the end of wie viel, it changes the meaning from how much to how many. So for example, wie viele Ecke hat ein Dreieck? Wie viele Ecke hat ein Dreieck? A Dreieck is a triangle. So, wie viele Ecke hat ein Dreieck? Drei. It's kind of obvious in German because Dreieck means three corners. Did you notice how many corners has a three corner? So, wie viele Einwohner wohnen in Salzburg? Wie viele Einwohner wohnen in Salzburg? How many residents live in Salzburg? How are we doing on time? Dialogue, page 26. Okay. as a vehicle? Für zwei?
Für zwei.
Zimmer?
Zimmer.
Für heute?
Heute.
Nach.
Ja.
Ich heiße
Maximus.
Which one are we?
Oh, you sit back there. Do you
yeah.
want to leave one?
Sure.
Sure.
Might as well. A lot of people left, so. Also, starting here. You're reading this from basically Angestellte and stuff, what it says.
Okay. Guten Morgen. Herr Smith, ich habe Ihre
Reservierung.
Für zwei.
Zimmer.
Mit Bad. Aber wir
bestehen.
Say that one time.
Stehen.
Mm-hmm.
Vor einem
Problem. Problem.
Was ist los?
Was ist los?
Hmm? Basically, what's up? What's going on?
Die Dusche.
In einem.
Der Zimmer.
Ist kaputt. It's broken. Kaputt. Okay?
How do you translate einem der Zimmer?
One of the rooms. Einer means one of, der means of the. So it's one of. Einem der Zimmer, one of the rooms. Basically. Right. And. Right here?
Das möchte
nicht. Das macht.
Das macht.
Nix. Ja.
Wir
können
die Pfannen benutzen.
Benutzen, yes. Okay. Next one.
No.
Hier. Noch eine.
Eine.
Schwierigkeit.
Schwierigkeit. Herr Smith. In der Zimmer kann man das Fenster nicht öffnen.
Öffnen. Ja. Yeah. Okay, next person. Sorry, at the top, was soll?
Was sollen wir tun?
Zimmer sind
unmöglich
zu bekommen. Die Stadt ist von Touristen überschwemmt. Basically, the room, it's impossible to get a room, and the city is swarmed with tourists. Bleiben wir da? Or starting there? Bleiben wir da?
Ihr Name wird da. Ich bin der zu
Müde.
Zimmersuche. Zu gehen.
Gehen.
Ja.
Geheim means secret. Okay, next. Starting sehr gut.
Sehr gut. Das kümmert.
100, it doesn't say it here, but the word for 100 is 100.
100.
Is breakfast included? And then right here, one word.
Jawohl.
It's like an extra yes. Okay. It's like ja means yes, and jawohl is like a super yes. Mm-hmm. Also, mark. So again, also gut.
Also gut. Heil.
Reisepässe. Basically, because whenever you go to hotels, because you're a tourist, you have to give them your passports. Because they're asking, so you, whenever you go in, and a lot of times you could just say, ich will einchecken, which is actually comes from an English word to check in, but the Germans have Germanized it. So you can say, ich will einchecken. And then they will ask you for your Reisepass, and then you hand it to them. And then they will tell you everything, where the room is, and all that stuff. Literally the up train. Zug is like a train, and auf means up, so it's like saying the train that goes up. Whenever the elevator was invented, the Germans didn't have like a proper word to say it, so they're just like the train that goes up. So. Also, next, natürlich.
Natürlich,
da. Dort. Dort. Drüben. Drüben. That, dort drüben means over there. Like if you're asking where something is, and they're like, dort drüben. Over there. Right. And
read X.
No, no, at mark.
Oh, sorry.
Oh. Wait, the German for thank you.
Oh, danke schön. Danke schön.
Danke schön. And then finally, right here.
Bitte, sir.
Bitte sehr.
Hey, sir. Ich.
Hoffe.
And you?
Unsere Stadt.
Also gesagt, geh wo hin.
Gefällt Ihnen.
Geh wo hin.
Yep. Basically, I hope that our city pleases you. For pronouns. These are the ways of saying something that builds out proper pronouns. Instead of saying Todd or John or Jaeger in my case, you would say these things. Ich is the first person singular I. Du is you, informally. Er, sie, es, the he, she, or it. Wir is we. Ihr is you all. Sie is also they, and sie is also a form of you and you all. So sie is used a lot in German. But the difference in the writing though, if you see, a lot of times understanding the sie is based on the conjugation of the verb and the context. Like if I'm talking directly to you and I say woher kommen sie, I mean when I'm talking to you formally. But if I say woher kommt sie, I'm referring to where does she come? Or if I'm talking to both of you and use form of her common Z, I mean you are plural. Does that make sense? So understanding Z is based on the context. In the writing though, the formal Z is always capitalized while the lower, this is lowercase. So in writing, that's how it's easy to tell, but speaking you can't see the writing. So context, whenever you hear it, is important. Verbs. In German there are three types of verbs, strong, weak, and irregular. We'll be focusing on some strong verbs and some irregular verbs. Strong verbs basically follow the endings, like if you have the verb kommen, or sagen, or fühlen, or tragen, or any verb that has that basic something with the en at the end, that's the infinitive, to something. Whenever that happens, you drop the en, and in strong verbs, you add these endings. So if it's you, like I, it gets an e. If it's your, it gets an st, or an est, if the verb ends with a d or t. It gets t in the he, she, it, en in we, t, and then en. And then en in both the formal, plural, and singular. Here's an example, kommen, to come. So, ich komme, du kommst, sie, es kommt, wir kommen, ihr kommt, sie kommen, sie kommen, und sie kommen. Now, using singen, how do you say I sing from those rules? So you have this verb, singen, and using these endings and this form, what would you say? I sing.
Singen.
So conjugate that for I sing. So ich.
Ich.
And then you drop your en. And what would you add?
Singest.
So if I drop the en from that, it's just zing. Which one of these endings for I would I use?
The second one.
This one's you. You want to say I.
Oh.
Which is ich. So ich.
Ich.
And then you add an e.
Ich.
Ich singe.
Ich singe.
Ich singe.
Ich singe.
Ich singe.
Mm-hmm. Good job. Use symbols. Say y'all do. Using the word machen. What's y'all informally?
We.
Y'all informally.
Yeah.
And conjugate machen. So you have machen right here, the second one. You want to drop the en and add the appropriate ending. Ihr was hier.
Ihr
macht.
Macht.
Ihr macht.
Ihr macht.
Okay. And then last one. Actually, those are the not. Here are some other verbs like sagen, haben, gehen, heißen, springen, möchten. These are all versions of strong verbs that follow this general guideline. So basically, you drop the ending, en, on all these. And then you add one of those conjugations depending on who's doing it. I, you, he, she, it, and so on. Irregular verbs. These are the four most important German verbs to know. Werden, haben, sein, und wollen. To become, to have, to be, and to want. To be is sein. As you tell, this is a irregular verb because it follows none of the rules that we just talked about. So, it goes, ich bin, I am. Du bist,
du bist.
Sie, es ist,
sie, es ist.
habe.
Ich habe.
Du hast.
Du hast.
Er hat.
Er hat.
Wir haben.
Wir haben.
Ihr habt.
Ihr habt.
Sie haben.
Sie haben.
Sie haben.
Sie haben.
Sie haben.
Sie haben.
Werden. Ich werde.
Ich werde.
Du wirst.
Du wirst.
Er wird.
Er wird.
Wir werden.
Wir werden.
Ihr werdet.
Ihr werdet.
Sie werden.
Sie werden.
Sie werden.
Sie werden.
Sie werden. Wollen. Ich will.
Ich will.
Du willst.
Du willst.
Er will.
Er will.
Wir wollen.
Wir wollen.
Ihr wollt.
Ihr wollt.
Action. This is a typo, it's supposed to be here. So this is typo. Wollt. And sie wollen?
Sie wollen.
Sie wollen.
Sie wollen.
Sie wollen. Okay. So next time, these are the things we're going to be focusing on. Our main objective will be finding a way around Germany. So we'll be focusing on like how to ask directions and things like that. Public transportation, like the S-Bahn, U-Bahn buses and things like that. Times and numbers, so you can ask for time, when those things come, how much something costs, things like that. Countries and languages, like what language you speak, what countries you're from, what asking someone what country they're from. And if we get around to it, we'll be also going to talk about road signs, camping, hiking, weather, dates, months, seasons, days, and weeks. So that's the goals for next week. Also, one other thing. In one of the dialogues, it mentioned floors in German, known as a Stock. In the dialogue, they talked about going to the dritten Stock, to the third floor. It's important to note that in Germany, floor numbers are designated differently in South America. Here, like, I'm on the first floor, but in Germany, this is not the first floor, this is the Erdgeschoss, the ground floor. What you call the second floor is the first floor in Germany. So it basically goes zero, or Erdgeschoss floor, and it goes one, two, else. So if you ever hear someone say dritten Stock, the third floor, they're talking about the fourth floor in the context of Americans. So I've seen people get confused with that before, where they say third floor, and they go to the wrong thing and be like, where am I? It's like, you're on the second floor. People are like, you said third floor. So, yeah. So that's the goals for everyone. We finished 4 minutes early. Hope that you all enjoyed, and I'll be sending that everyone's here to hear this, but I'm going to send the next thing, hopefully this time it possibly gets to you, on the next lessons to work on before you get here.
It was sent to them, but they didn't have much time, so I said,
yeah, I don't understand.
And then I don't know if I can get this PowerPoint electronically so we can get the people who missed a few.
I can give it to you,
okay,
yeah. If anything, I'm just going to at least send it to you so you at least have it on the computer. If you don't